Underlying every organism is a plethora of genetic variation that enables populations to evolve. As a wise ogre named Shrek once said, individuals in a population are like onions, they have layers, or something like that. Genetic variation is the presence of genetic differences within the genome of an organism that allow populations to adapt to changes, whether it be from disease, climate change, genetic drift, or deforestation. Evolution is completely limited by the amount of genetic variation in a population, a problem identified by Richard Lewontin and John Hubby in their 1966 paper entitled A Molecular Approach to the Study of Genetic Heterozygosity in Natural Populations, Amount of Variation and Degree of Heterozygosity in Natural Populations of Drosophila pseudoobscura. This paper, with a really catchy title, would later go on to completely revolutionise evolutionary biology and the study of variability. Before we can truly understand the importance of these papers, we need to back up a bit. Back in the 1950s, very little was understood about the state of a gene, and most had never heard of the term genetic variation. There was strong debate over what was termed the classical view versus the balanced view of variability. The classical view believed that the wild-type version of an allele was the only one, and any changes to this were the result of rare mutations. On the other hand, the balanced view suggested that some genes might have multiple alleles, maintained by balancing selection. Balancing selection holds segregating alleles at intermediate frequencies, and rare alleles are favored by selection until they are no longer rare, and hence stop being under selection. Back then, however, there was no way to actually test these hypotheses. This all changed when two papers were published by genetics pioneers Hubby and Lewontin that discovered a completely new way to measure genetic variation: whole genome studies using gel electrophoresis. The first paper came up with this system, and the second paper tested it out on 43 lines of the American fruit fly Drosophila pseudoobscura. They looked at the levels of heterozygosity, which is the presence of two different alleles at a particular loci, and can be used to estimate the genetic variation within a population. This was the first time variation could be observed at the molecular level. Before this, there were no techniques that could satisfy the four ideal conditions to successfully and accurately test the level of heterozygosity in a population. In the first paper, the electrophoresis mechanism discovered met all the criteria except the third, that a substantial amount of allelic substitutions must be distinguishable from each other. However, they were able to fix this in the second experiment. In the second paper, Hubby and Lewontin chose loci from the flies that were completely random, so they had no previous knowledge of variability. The protein and enzyme electrophoresis of the fly loci detected charge change variants. I'm sure we're all familiar with gel electrophoresis, but let me break it down for you. Let's consider two people, a parent and a child, navigating their way through an obstacle course to reach a prize at the end. Due to the nature of the course, the smaller child can easily weave in and out of the obstacles. The parent, however, struggles to fit and moves much slower. This is the principle behind gel electrophoresis, where a size-discriminatory matrix gel results in separation of negatively charged proteins and enzymes that are driven to the positive electrode at the other end. By measuring the electrophoretic mobility of the proteins, that is, the rate of migration divided by the electric field strength, Lewontin and Hubby were able to determine that the amount of genetic variation in the loci of the fly's genome was 39%. This is a conservative estimate to account for bias and is still much higher than expected by chance. This was an incredible and surprising result, and Lewontin and Hubby concluded that there was no simple explanation for the maintenance of such large amounts of genic heterozygosity. After these papers were published, the use of electrophoresis in evolutionary genetics skyrocketed. Within 15 years of the paper's release, over 1,000 papers adopted the electrophoresis technique to measure variability. Just like the iconic 2001 film Shrek, which completely reimagined the cliché repetitive Disney fairy tales, this technique discovered by Lewontin and Hubby completely changed evolutionary biology forever.